What's up, my F-A-G-G-O-T's? Hey!
Ha ha ha! Vicky Legs, here for, you guessed it, another Monday on Queer Comics. Right there. Una, get off the couch! Get off the couch! What do you think this is? A hotel? This week is a real humdinger for our topic. We are talking about being politically correct and censorship. That. So they're kind of two different topics lumped together, really. They seem like the same thing, but they're not. There's a little bit of difference. I should probably look up what that is. 1 second, please. All right, so we're looking this up. So political correctness, or PC for short, means using words or behavior which will not offend any group of people. Huh. And the other one. 1 second. Censorship is the name for the process or idea of keeping things like obscene words or graphic images from an audience. Ah, yes, 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 yes. I know, I know. I think for any career specifically, this topic, I think it relates to comedians. More than any other career there is, really. Well, any kind of performer, essentially, has to be aware of being politically correct and censorship. That is always something that's in the back of our minds. I haven't really had to deal with dumbing my act down, but it probably comes with the territory of being a drag queen. I think people expect that from me. I think what this allows me is it's so loud and outspoken as it is, just visually, that it gives me a bit of an allowance to kind of say what I really want to say. I'm not really somebody who gets offended by stuff. You can kind of say whatever you want to me as long as you don't go to a personal level. If you take it to a personal level, I'm gonna get right in your face! Do I think it's important to have political correctness, or when do I think it's gone too far? I think there are two very extreme camps of thinking when it comes to this. One is very clean, it's very, you know, they won't curse, they won't any of that. They won't even say God. That is out of the question for them. So that is that mind. And then there's also people who just swear every second. Every second word is fuck, 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 fuck. You know, censoring everything that you think or say, that's not healthy. And it's certainly not healthy to have zero filter and say everything that you just think immediately and hurt people's feelings all the time. That's not healthy for anybody. So I think it's really about finding a balance. My thought on words are kind of like guns. Guns don't kill people. People kill people. The same thing with words. Words don't hurt people. People hurt people. It's all about the context of who the words are coming from. Things like the N-word, which again I won't say, just out of respect to anybody who may be offended by that, I don't know. But it's... when you put power into such a word, and I understand the context of which that was used, and how debilitating and hurtful that word was, and has been and still is in a lot of places. I think if you can't take the power back from a word, you become a victim. And you kind of remain that victim. And I think that's the problem with a lot of words. One of my favorite words ever is cunt. I love saying cunt. Cunt, 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 cunt. Driving on the country road. I remember a time where saying cunt was on the same level as saying the N-word. Something happened. Something happened. Women took that word back. They reclaimed the word. I don't know if it was the vagina monologues, I'm not sure. I mean, people have hats and like necklaces that say cunt on them. They walk around town with cunt on their clothes. I mean, it's such an accepted word now, but at one point, I mean, that was definitely on par with saying, and the N-word. You couldn't do it. I mean, I say cunt in every context. I can say, oh, she's a real cunt, as in, she's not nice. Or I can say, ooh, you girl, you a real cunt, as in, look at that face, you look good. So I think my real issue would be with censorship. I think that is where a lot of our societal problems come from. I I literally have so many issues with censorship. I can't even get into it. I can't even. The naked body is so taboo in our culture. In comparison to having somebody's skull crushed in about 50 times, that's much more acceptable for us to be watching than somebody's naked body. Guess what? We were all born naked. We all evolved naked. This stuff just happened during this period that I'm coming from right now. We all have a very Victorian mindset on our morals, on our, you know, societal structure, everything. It's just so old-fashioned, so archaic, and we're not looking forward. We keep going backwards. I don't think porn necessarily is a terrible thing. Do I think a two-year-old should be watching porn? Of course not. But I think it's about, you know, everybody just kind of accepting sex, sexuality, accepting our bodies for what they are, and introducing people to that sooner. You know, violence is kind of compared to nudity and pornography. They're all on kind of the same level. And for me, there's no comparison. It's the goddamn fucking violence that's happening in this world every single day. And that is because we are overexposed to all this violence everywhere. I'm so exhausted by this issue. I guess the nugget I want you to take from this is, do not try and offend people. You can try and push people's buttons and try and change thought processes for the better, yes. But do not try and personally offend somebody, because that is toxic. We don't need that in the world. Hi, puppy. Thank you again for indulging my bitch fest. It is cathartic as fuck. Fuck it real hard. Fuck, 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 fuck. Fuck on your fuck, 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 fuck. Tranny.